Now in this video, I start the chapter Straight Lines. Now this is the exercise 2, difficulty level is medium, straight lines, MC problems. The first problem, if the slope of the line passing through the points minus 8, 3, 2, 1 is parallel to the line through the points 11, minus 1, k, 0, then what is the value of k? See here, two lines are given. This is the first line joining the points minus 8, 3 and 2, 1. And this is the second line joining the points 11, minus 1 and k, 0. Now, the two lines are parallel to each other. Then what is the value of k? Two lines are parallel means slopes are equal. So, finding the slopes values, slope of the first line m1 is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. That is 1 minus 3 minus 2 by 2 minus minus 8. That is 10 equals to minus 1 by 5. And m2 is equal to slope of the second line 0 minus minus 1 plus 1 by k minus 11. But what is the given data? The two lines are parallel. That is equating the slopes values. The two lines are parallel means slopes are equal. Now taking the cross product, minus 2k plus 22 is equal to 10. That is 2k is equal to 12. That is the value of k is equal to 6. That's all. Exam number 2. If each of the points a, 4, minus 2, b lies on the line joining the points 2, minus 1, 5, minus 3, then the point a, b lies on the line. So given that the points a, 4 and minus 2, b lies on the line joining these two points. That is, first we have to find the equation of the line passing through these two points. And we substitute these two points in that line equation to find the point a comma b. So first, I take the equation of the line passing through these two points. Writing the two points here, the points are 2 comma minus 1, 5 comma minus 3. Now what is the slope value? M is equals to y2 minus y1. That is minus 2 by x2 minus x1 is equal to 3. Now what is the equation of the line formula? Y minus y1 is equals to m into x minus x1. I take that x1 y1 is equal to this point, then y minus y1, y plus 1 is equal to minus 2 by 3 into x minus 2. That is equals to, taking the cross product, 3y plus 3 is equal to minus 2x plus 4. Therefore, equation of line is 2x plus 3y minus 1 is equal to 0. So, this is the equation of the line passing through the given points. Now, what is the given data? The point a comma 4 and minus 2 comma b lies on this line. So, first replacing the point a comma 4 in this equation. Then what we get? 2a plus 12 minus 1 plus 11 is equal to 0. That is the value of a is equal to minus 11 by 2. Next, minus 2 comma b. Minus 2 comma b point lies on this line. That is, minus 4 plus 3b minus 1 is equal to 0. That is, the value of b is equal to 5 by 3. Now, these two are the a comma b values. Now, the point a comma b lies on the line. Just to take the options verification. Now, I take the third option here, option 3. Replacing the values in the option 3. Option 3 is equal to 2x plus 6y plus 1 is equal to 0. Now replacing a comma b values, 2 into minus 11 by 2 plus 6 into 5 by 3 plus 1. Now this is equals to minus 11 plus 11 is equal to 0. Yes, this is the correct answer. Option 3 is the only correct option. This is the only satisfied by the values a comma b. Finding three options are not satisfied here. So check once all of you. Sum number 3. If the lines y is equal to minus 3x plus 4, ay is equal to x plus 10 and 2y plus bx plus 9 is equal to 0 represents the three consecutive sides of a rectangle. So here in the given question, three consecutive sides of a rectangle are given. That is, the first equation y is equal to minus 3x plus 4. Second equation ay is equal to x plus 10. Third equation 2y plus bx plus 9 is equal to 0. Now, what is the value of the aim to be? So, given that these are the three consecutive sides of a rectangle, that is, in a rectangle, opposite sides are parallel and adjacent sides are perpendicular. That is, these two lines are parallel. What is the meaning of the parallel? Slopes are equal. What is the slope of this line? Minus 3. Y is equal to mx plus a. What is the slope of this line? Minus a by b. Minus b by 2. What is the slope of this line? Y is equal to 1 by a into x plus 10 by a. That is, m is equal to 1 by a. Y is equal to mx plus c4. M is equal to 1 by a. Since these two lines are parallel, slopes are equal. That is, minus 3 is equal to minus b by 2. Therefore, b is equal to 6 here. And since these two lines are perpendicular, m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. That is, 1 by a into minus 3 is equal to minus 1. Therefore, a is equal to 3. What is the given question? The value of the AB. What is the value of AB? A into B is equals to 18. That is the first option. Next, sum number 4. The equation of the straight line cutting off and intercepts 8 on the x-axis, making an angle of 60 degrees with the positive direction of the y-axis. That is, the equation of the straight line. These are coordinate axes. The equation of the straight line making an intercept of 8 on the x-axis. Intercept of 8 on the x-axis means this point is equal to 8, comma 0. And making an angle of 60 degrees with the positive direction of the y-axis. This angle is given. Positive direction of the y-axis. That is, this value is equal to 60. This value is equal to 60 degrees. Now, what is the total value? The angle made by the line with the x-axis is equals to, the angle made by the line with the x-axis is equal to 90 plus 60. That is, total is equal to 150 here. So, here angle made by the line with the x-axis is equal to 150. So, theta is equal to 150. Then, what is slope value? M is equal to tan theta, tan 150. Tan 150 is equal to tan 180 minus 30. Tan 180 minus 30 is equal to minus tan 30. Minus tan 30 is equal to minus 1 by root 3. Now, what is the equation of the line? That is the given question. So, equation of the line is formula y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. That is, y minus 0 is equal to minus 1 by root 3 into x minus z. Now, taking the cross product, root 3y is equal to minus x plus 8. That is, the answer is x plus root 3y is equal to 8. That is the second option. Next problem, sum number 5. If minus 4 comma 5 is one vertex and 7x minus 4y plus 8 is equal to 0, one diagonal of a square, then what is the equation of the other diagonal? So, here, one square is given. This is the square and one vertex is given. This is the vertex minus 4 comma 5 and one diagonal is given. This is the given diagonal 7x minus 5 plus 8 is equal to 0. Now observe that this is the line which is not passing through this vertex since the point is not satisfied by this equation. When we replace this point in this equation, then what we get? Minus 28 minus 5 plus 8, which is not equal to 0. So, this is not the diagonal passing through this point. So, we draw the diagonal like that. Okay. This is the second diagonal not passing through the given vertex since this is not satisfied by the given point. Now, what is the given question? We want the second diagonal equation. We want this equation. So, what is this equation? Now, clearly here, these two lines are perpendicular to each other. Clearly, here these two lines are perpendicular to each other. That is, the second diagonal is nothing but the perpendicular equation of this line. Perpendicular equation. What is the perpendicular equation formula? Bx minus ay plus k is equal to 0. Perpendicular equation of ax plus by plus a is equal to 0. That is, bx minus ay plus k is equal to 0. Now, what are ab values? A is equal to 7, b is equal to minus 1. That is, minus 1 into x minus 7y plus k is equal to 0. Now, taking minus cancellation, then we get x plus 7y minus k is equal to 0. how to take the k value now, replacing the given one. X comma y is equal to minus 4 comma 5. That is minus 4 plus 35 minus k is equal to 0, means k is equal to 31. Now replacing this k value in this equation, therefore the answer is x plus 7y minus 31 is equal to 0. So here the second diagonal is nothing but the perpendicular equation of the first diagonal, and we can take the perpendicular line equation by using the formula bx minus ay plus k equal to 0. Very easy problem. Next one, sum number 6. Equation of the line which passes through the point minus 3 comma 8 and cut off positive intercepts on the axis whose sum is equal to 7. Equation of the line passing through the point minus 3 comma 8. Just to take the options verification, option 1 is equals to 3x minus 4y is equal to 12. Now substituting the point, then what we get? Minus 9 minus 32 is equals to 12. So this is not the correct answer. Now replacing the point in the second option, minus 12 plus 24 is equal to 12. Yes, this is the correct answer. Now checking the remaining two options also, minus replacing the point in the third option, minus 9 plus 32 which is equals to 12, which is not correct, and the replacing the point in the last option, minus 12 minus 24 is equal to 12, which is not the correct answer. So answer is the only second option. This is the correct one. The next question, the number of lines that are parallel to 2x plus 6y minus 7 equal to 0 and having an intercept of 10 between the coordinate axis. The number of lines that are parallel to the given line. So here, first I take the coordinate axis, x-axis and y-axis, and this is the given line. What is the given line here? 2x plus 6y minus 7 is equal to 0. If suppose just I take that the length of this line is equal to, if suppose 6, that is the line is intercepted between the coordinate axis, the length of the line between the coordinate axis is equal to 6 here. Now suppose just I take that this value is equal to 6. What is the given quotient? The number of lines that are parallel to given line and have an intercept of 10 between the coordinate axis. Now just I draw one line here. Suppose this is the line parallel to the given line. Suppose this is the line parallel to the given line and having an intercept is equal to 10 between the coordinate axis. The length of the line between the coordinate axis is equal to 10 here. Okay, this is the required line. What's the given quotient? We want the number of lines having an intercept is equal to 10 between the coordinate axis. Suppose this is the first line. Now we can draw the same type of line in the third quadrant also. This is also the line which is parallel to the given line and also having the intercept of 10 is equals to, intercept is equal to 10 between the coordinate axis. So this is also the line that is parallel to given line with intercept is equal to 10. That is, how many number of lines we have here? The number of lines is equal to 2, such that length of the intercept is equal to 10 and parallel to given line between the coordinate axis. So answer is equal to 2. The number of lines that are parallel to the given line and have intercept is equal to 10 between the coordinate axis. Number of existing lines is equals to 2 here. That's all. That is the answer. Next question, sum number 8. If the line x minus y plus 1 plus k into y minus 2x plus 4 is equal to 0 makes equal intercepts on the axis, then what is the value of the k? So here one equation is given. The equation is x minus y plus 1 plus k into y minus 2x plus 4 is equal to 0. This is the given equation. So first I multiply this total equation and converting this line in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. First I multiply this equation here and making into ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Now what is the first step? First writing the x value, x into 1, x into minus 2k. So first this is the x step, x into 1, x into minus 2k. Now writing the y term. What is y term? Here y quotient is equals to minus 1. Here y quotient is equals to k. Y into minus 1 plus k. What is the constant? 1 plus 4k. 1 plus 4k is equal to 0. That is, without multiplying them directly, I can take the equation here. First, writing the x term by taking the quotients common. Next, y term by writing the quotients common and constant. Now, this is in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. What is the given data? The line makes equal intercepts. The line makes equal intercepts means the condition is a is equals to b. These two values are equal. A is equal to b, then the given line makes equal intercepts. That is, therefore, a is equal to b means 1 minus 2k is equal to minus 1 plus k. That is, 3k is equal to 2, then the value of k is equal to 2 by 3. That's all. This is the answer. Sum number 9. The equation of the set of lines which are at a constant distance 2 units from the origin. So, equation of set of lines, the lines are at a distance of 2 units from the origin. So, here the distance from line to origin is given. This value is given. This is equals to P value. P is equal to 2. The length of the perpendicular from origin to the given straight line. So, this is P is equal to 2. Now, what is the equation of the line? That is a given question. Now, what is the equation of the line in the normal form? X cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to P here. What is P value? P is equal to the distance from origin to the straight line. Already here given that P is equal to 2. Then what is the equation of the line? X cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to 2. Given that P is equal to 2. So answer is equal to x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to 2. That's all. That is the answer. Now sum number 10. The slope of the straight line passing through the point A3, comma 2 is 3 by 4. Then what are the coordinates of two points on the line that are 5 units from the point A? So here one straight line is given. This is the straight line. Given that slope of the line is equal to 3 by 4. The slope of the straight line is equal to 3 by 4. And the straight line passes through the point A3, comma 2. This is the line passing through the point A3, comma 2. What are the coordinates of the points which are 5 units from the point A? Suppose these are the required points, P, comma Q. What is given? These are the points at a distance of 5 units from this point. Now, to find the coordinates of these two points, we use the formula x1 plus or minus r cos theta, comma y1 plus or minus r sin theta. This is the formula to find the coordinates of the two points. Now, what are the values here? x1, y1 is equal to given point and r is equal to given distance, that is equals to 5. Now, what are sin theta, cos theta values? Already in the given question, we have the value of the m. M is equal to 3 by 4. But what is m formula? M is equal to tan theta. So, what is sin theta value? 3 by 5. And what is cos theta value? 4 by 5. Now, replacing all these values in the formula. Therefore, answer is equals to, replacing the values, x1, 3 plus or minus r value 5, cos theta value 4 by 5. And y1 value 2 plus or minus r value 5, sin theta value 3 by 5. That is equals to 3 plus or minus 4 comma 2 plus or minus 3. That is 3 plus 4 comma 2 plus 3. This is the first point. And second point is 3 minus 4 comma 2 minus 3. That is 7 comma 5. And this is minus 1 comma minus 1. That is the second option. Now I will continue the remaining sums in the next video.